Good afternoon, friends. My name is Navin Kumar. Welcome to Classic Online Classes. So, yesterday we are discussing about the RBI main functions, right? So, we discussed the two points of the main functions, right? So, in that third part was remaining. So, we are going to discuss today that is the third part, that is promotional functions. What is the promotional functions? Means through the RBI, what are the promotions are going on? Means by the RBI, which some other organizations under working to the RBI, right? On the part of the RBI, like that. So let me see the first point here, friends. Establishment of financial institutions like IDBI, SIDBI, IFCI, then ICICI, IRBI, right? So these are the financial institutions, right, friends? Comes under the RBI, okay? It's promoted by the RBI. So let me see the second point here, right? I'm talking about the first point only. Every institutions work in the different part of the different sector here, right, friends? So for example, it's a SIDBI, small scale industries, right? Then IDBI, right? Then IFCI, then ICICI, then IRBI. Next one, we talked that ECGC, right? And different NHB, right? Like that. So now come to the second point here. Promotion of agricultural by establishment of NABARD. Yesterday we discussed about this one, right? About NABARD. So National Bank for Agricultural and Rural Development, right? And Agricultural College at Pune, right, friends? When I'm telling about the institutions, right? Research centers and institutions, right? RBI colleges like institutions means Agricultural College at Pune. So promotion of NABARD means NABARD, it is a purely comes under the RBI and helps to financing for the RRBs. We call it as a apex organization. NABARD is called as one more name is a apex organization funding to the RRBs. Okay, next point number three, promotion of regional rural banks, RRBs. When we see that chart, okay, I told you commercial banks, public sector banks, then foreign banks, private banks like RRBs. So promotion of RRBs means regional rural banks and thereby extending banking facilities to the rural areas. Why this particularly that RBI promoting the RRBs means to reach the every corner of the country, every district of the country to get the facilities to the agriculture, facilities to the farmers, right, friends? So in case of that, they are promoting the RRBs, right, friends? Next point here. Development of foreign trade by helping in establishment of the export import bank and facilitating the opening of branches in the foreign centers by Indian banks, right, friends? When you call it Exim, Export and Import Bank of India, right, what the goods are going from our country to another country and what we are accepting from a goods from another country to our country, that this all the whatever the transactions or whatever the business is going on, this we call it as a foreign trade, right, on the basis of promotion of RBI, then and also opening the branches in the foreign centers by Indian banks also, right? In the foreign countries, some of the branches also are there, right? It may be financial institution or as a public sector banks, right? Next year, point number five, development of money market by helping in establishment of Discount and Finance Housing of India Limited, right? So it is also so money market related of a financial by helping in establishment of Discount and Finance House of India Limited, right, friends? So next point here, promotion of housing sector by establishment of NHB, right? I told you yesterday what NHB does the work, right? Yeah, what are the main process of NHB? So NHB is a financing for a housing loan for all the banks. So this is the main of so promotion of RBI to finance the housing loan to all the banks, right, friends? Next year, establishment of Deposit Insurance and Credit Guarantee Corporation of India, that is a DICGC, right? It is an insurance, deposit insurance. I told you whatever the goods are going outside from our country, they are getting the deposit insurance, which where it go by the ship or plane, like, right? So then for that product we are getting a insurance on this on the basis of the financial institution. Okay, friends. Yes, these 6 points are the promotional functions are there, right? I just telling about the, not briefly, just I'm telling about the points and some hints, that's it, okay? Okay, the upcoming next days, the classes will be going on, right? Then offline classes. In the classes, we are going to explain briefly and giving the information of all the institutions and whatever it may be we are studying here. So let me see the types of banks yesterday we studied, and once again I'll repeat this one. Okay, the first comes in one, the types of banks, the Minister of Finance will come the first point, then RBI, and as well as the schedule banks. When the schedule banks comes, again it will take the two parts here, commercial banks, right friends? One is a public sector bank, then private sector, then foreign banks, then regional rural banks here, that is in the commercial banks. When you go to the cooperative banks, that is a urban cooperative banks and as well as a state cooperative banks. Okay, this is the structure of Indian banking system, right friends? Okay, right, so this is very important friends. Okay, in every examination, right, or it might be in interview also, the questions are asked particularly on the basis of this, some facts about banks in India. Compulsory questions will come in this particular topic, right? Why I'm telling means, these are the, see, already since from the whatever the in the previous decade the bank starts, or the governor, okay, or any introduction of any machine, right, or establishment, right, like that, or maybe it may be a currency, or it may be any licenses, okay, who got the first license. So every information we can get here in the this some facts about in banks in India. Why I'm telling this one you, because right, on the cases of this, many questions arrived in your previous examination also, and some questions asked in your interview also. So this topic is very important here. Let me see what is the first point. We'll go by point to point, right friends? Here, first point here, first Indian bank got ISO number. Okay, ISO, the Indian Standards Organization. So which bank got the ISO number first in India? That is Canara Bank. Okay, you all to get to know that. Okay, Canara Bank is the first bank that got the ISO number, okay, in India, first bank, right? Next one here, first governor of RBI, right friends? Yesterday I told you, when it was established April 1st 1935, who is the first governor of RBI? See, April 1st 1935, still we didn't get the freedom. So on that time, the British person was a governor of this particular, right, organization. So the first governor of the RBI, Mr. Osborne Smith, right friends? Osborne Smith. Same the question again, the next question will be changed. Who is the first Indian governor of RBI? Like that, okay? That's also I yesterday discussed with you. Third point is first Indian governor of RBI. The first Indian governor means after the independence. The first Indian governor of RBI, Mr. C.D. Deshmukh. Right friends? Okay. Then point number four here. First bank to introduce ATM in India. It's a very important one here. Who introduced the first ATM in India? Like this question comes in your examination. So by seeing the question, we can predict easily, right? By seeing the options, which is the right answer, okay? Before that, we get to know the previous history of these, all the banking, okay, sectors and the financial sectors, right? So first bank to introduce ATM in India, that is HSBC, Hong Kong Shanghai Banking Corporation, right? It's a foreign bank, okay? The first ATM introduced by HSBC. Next year, first bank to introduce a savings account in India. This is very important, friends. Why I am telling means a savings account. The many questions arrives in the related to the savings account about the interest, right? About the some of the rules and regulations of KYC, what they have to submit, right, friends? And as well as here, the question comes is the first bank to introduce savings bank in India. Savings, okay, savings bank in India. That is Presidency Banks. The Presidency Bank means, now it started by the Bank of Kolkata, again name changed by Bank of Bengal, then three banks merged, Bank of Bengal, Bank of Mumbai, then Bank of Madras, and become as a Presidency Bank. Again it name changed as a Presidency, right now it has a State Bank of India, present the name is State Bank of India. So which bank introduced savings bank in India, that is Presidency Banks in 1883, you should remember this one, right friends, with name and year, 1883. Let me see the point number, next one here, the first bank to introduce check system in India. Okay, who introduced the check system? They are asking the first time in India. They are asking a Bengal bank, right friends? The Bengal bank has introduced the first check system in India at 1784, right friends? 1784, right here, the last point here, the first bank to introduce internet banking, right? Who introduced the internet banking in India first time? That is a private sector bank, that is ICICI. Okay, ICICI bank here. Okay, let me see the next point, friends. Here, first bank to introduce mutual funds, right, friends? That is a State Bank of India, the first bank to introduce the mutual funds, that is State Bank of India. And one more questions will come, right, friends? You have to remember that one, okay? I'm not mentioning that one here. Just I'm telling you, explaining that part here. Who introduced the first mutual funds in India, right? See, first bank to introduce, they asked the question, first bank. But what I'm saying, who introduced the first mutual funds in India, that is United Trust of India. Right, friends? So United Trust of India just introduced the mutual funds first time in India, right? In year of 1963, I think so. Yes, 1963. Then after that, in 1980 or 1980, then UTI, that is a United merged with SBI, then the first bank to introduce mutual funds in India, that is a State Bank of India. Don't confuse them. If they ask in examination, who introduced the first mutual funds in India, if the options are two options are given there, means for example State Bank of India is also there, that United Trust of India also is there, means you have to see the year who introduced the first. They are asking the question, see the question, who introduced first, means they are not using the name as a bank. They're only asking about the who introduced the mutual funds in India, like that, right, friends? So that is United Trust of India. When they ask this one particularly, which bank introduced the first mutual funds in India, means that is State Bank of India. Understood, friends? Okay. Next point here. First bank to introduce credit card in India, that we almost we using the debit cards and credit cards, right, friends? Okay. Everyone having the debit card already here, right? Then only few people having the credit card. Why? Because when we survey that, by seeing the survey out of banks, right, 90 crore people are using the debit cards, and 2 to 3 crores or maximum 4 crores are people using the credit cards, right, friends? So that is a Central Bank of India. Central Bank of India, the first bank to introduce a credit card in India, right, friends? Next point here, first bank set up in India, that is first point only we discussed in the first class, that is a first bank set up in India, means which bank established the first time in India, means that is a Bank of Hindustan, right, in 1770, Kolkata, right, friends? Say Bank of Hindustan in 1770. Next up, yesterday I told you in the previous class, first joint stock bank of British in India, right? First joint stock bank of British in India, means, see, the word is coming here, first joint stock. Then, see, you have to read the full question, don't confuse it here. First joint stock bank of British India, means that is State Bank of India, right? Then don't put the Allahabad Bank, okay? Why? Because they see the question here properly, Bank of British in India, that is State Bank of India. When the next point is, first joint stock bank and oldest public bank in India, that is Allahabad Bank. The question comes like this, which is the oldest and oldest public sector and the joint stock bank of India, means that is Allahabad Bank. Right? The question comes like this, which is the first joint stock bank British India, means that is State Bank of India. Understood, friends? Okay, that is State Bank of India. Same, the next point is the first joint stock. See, joint stock means, I told you, a number of shareholders, okay, more number of partners in that particular organization. So that is we call as a joint stock. Okay, friends. So that is the first joint stock bank and the oldest public bank in India, that is Allahabad Bank. Okay, friends. Okay, we'll move for the next one now. Right here. Next point here, first bank in India launched a talking ATM for different able persons, right? Which is the ATM, bank in India launched the talking ATM? We are already processing the ATM by putting the debit cards, right? So we are using the cards and entering the PIN numbers, and some of the new technologies coming go through the banking, right? Okay, by giving the thumb impressions or eye retina, but still it's not in the process, right? In big cities like that, okay? But here in India, first time, the first bank in India launched a talking ATM for different able persons. They're asking, right? That is a Union Bank of India, right, friends? Okay, next point here. First Indian bank to launch its own payment aggregator is SBI, means SBI e-payment. For example, see, own payment aggregator is that is SBI means SBI e-payment. Now we all are using that Google Pay, Phone Pay and some other things now, right? Same in the public sector, the first application like this are introduced by the SBI, that is SBI e-payment, right friends? Next year, first national bank that was merged with the PNB, which is the national bank, the merged with PNB means that is a new Bank of India in 1993. It's merged with the PNB. Before it is also part of in the public sector bank only, but it merged in 1993 with PNB, right? Two banks become as one, that is we call it as a Punjab National Bank, right friends? So which bank means new Bank of India. Next point here, first Indian bank to open branches outside India. See, we all are having many branches. It means, for example, in our country, many banks have many different branches in different states also. Apart from that, right, in public sector banks having the branches in the foreign countries also, right, in different countries. That is which the question is asking like this, first Indian bank to open branches outside India. Which is the first bank, they open their branches in the foreign country. Okay, that is a Bank of India in London, 1946. Right friends? Okay. Next year, first Indian bank started with the Indian capital, Indigenous Bank of India, right? Indian capital means no other shareholders, only investment of our own peoples, only maintained by Indians, that is a Punjab National Bank. Right friends? Okay, PNB we called as. Okay, next points here. First RRB name means Regional Rural Bank, right? So Regional Rural Bank means when we see that many regional rural banks are there, but now they merged and again merging of some of the banks now become only few banks are there, right? So the question is like this, the first RRB name, which is the first RRB established, which hand, what is the name anta kelthakanta dili friends, that is a Prathama Gramina Bank, right? Now we can have the Karnataka Vikasa Gramina Bank, right? Pragati Krishna Gramina Bank, Kaveri Bank, right? Different banks are there. Now means that is in RRBs, but they are asking the which is the first bank in the RRB, that is Prathama Gramina Bank was started by who, means a syndicate bank, means the sponsored by syndicate bank. You have to remember this one. Okay, next point here, first bank to provide mobile ATM, right friends? Mobile ATM, who introduced the mobile ATM in India first time? That is a ICICI Bank, right friends? I think almost all you people know this one, ICICI Bank. Why? Because you people are using these services, right? Next year, largest public sector bank of India and the largest bank with the foreign offices, right? Largest public sector bank and the largest bank with foreign offices. Which bank means? Obviously, we know that option is SBI. The State Bank of India is the largest bank and also having n number of branches in the different countries. Okay friends, next, largest private sector bank of India, which is the largest private sector bank of India, that is HDFC, Housing Development Finance Corporation. That is HDFC is a private bank, is the largest private sector bank in India. Next, last question here, first public sector bank to implement CBS. Okay, that is CBS means core banking solutions. In the upcoming class, I'll tell you what the CBS, when we study about terms, what the banking terms, right? Then CBS will come there. So first public sector banks to implement CBS core banking solution means that is a syndicate bank. Right friends? Okay. Fine friends, these are the points what we discussed, right? Some facts and promotional functions of RBI. Right, in the upcoming class we'll come with a new topic, right friends? So in the next upcoming days, we are offline classes are going to start now, right? So this what I'm telling about this, all the some important points and some important topics to you people. Why? Because the exam IBPS PO mains exam is very near, so you get to know that okay, how the questions will arise in the particular parts in the banking awareness. So by seeing all this, you get to know that okay, which topic you have to cover and which they have to be concentrated, right? In the further classes, right, I come with the previous question papers and the section wise, the topic wise, in the how many questions they asked in the banking awareness, static, current affairs and some difference, right? With analysis, doing the analysis of that, right, we can judge it, okay, which we have to cover it in this particular topic. right? And helpful for this one. I'm also going to solve some previous question papers also, 18 and 19. By seeing the questions, you get to know that how the questions will arise. Right, friends? Okay. So, today is, we discussed these all topics. I hope you understand these all things, right? So, subscribe, like our channel and share it, right? Thank you very much.